You, give me a Marlboro.
Yes, of course, right away. What's a Marlboro?
Just a cigarette, any cigarette.
Smoking is not good for you. It has been deemed that anything not good for you is bad. Hence, illegal. Alcohol, caffeine, contact sports, meat.
Are you shitting me?
John Spartan, you are fined one penny for a violation of the verbal morality statute.
What the hell is that?
John Spartan, you are fined one
penny. Bad language, chocolate, gasoline, uneducational toys, and anything spicy. Abortion is also illegal, but then again, so is pregnancy if you don't have a license.
Kim, what's on your radar?
Well, yesterday, as I was talking to you about the World Economic Forum's infiltration of governments with their members from their global young leaders program, Klaus Schwab, particularly giddy about being able to fill half of Canada's cabinet with its members, this video clip from 2018 happened to begin trending online.
A federated digital ID ecosystem developed in collaboration with Canada's best and brightest talent from our banks, telecommunication companies, law enforcement, and government. It would have the power and security to store every Canadian's electronic identity and attributes. And it would unlock countless opportunities for Canadians to verify who they are safely, quickly, and securely, while only revealing the information necessary for each transaction. A fast, easy, and secure way to bank, sign up for government services, renew driver's licenses or health cards, shop, travel, and more. Canada's banks are perfectly situated to help lead the creation of a federated digital ID system between government and the private sector. The World Economic Forum agrees that banks and financial institutions should lead the path forward for digital ID.
Yeah, trust the World Economic Forum and banks, says this guy. They're the right people to help keep our data safe and secure. The WEF and banks are quite literally the world's wealthiest and elite, and their track record doesn't exactly prove they have the best interest of average people in mind. Now look, digitizing certain information is without a doubt convenient. I love being able to leave my house without my purse, knowing my credit cards are stored on my phone for unexpected trips to 7-Eleven. And I'm sure there are a number of benefits from moving to digital identification that they, the ominous they, will use to sell us on. And let's start there with the ominous they. Why are they actively pushing for this concept of a digital society? Usually advancements in technology happen naturally as more and more people adopt the new thing, the old thing becomes a relic. For example, neither the government, nor banks, nor elite came out advocating for me to switch from cassette tapes to CDs and then on to MP3s. None of the elites have told me I must use my Apple wallet rather than carry around my plastic cards. People either adopt the new advancement or they don't. No one is being forced into it. Some people can still carry around cash, and they won't even use plastic, let alone Apple Pay. But what's odd about digital identification system is that rather than just rolling them out and letting those who want to use them, it's being advocated for by bankers and elites and pushed for by the World Economic Forum, not as a choice, but as a requirement. They're hoping governments adopt a federated digital identification system rather than private companies offering it as a convenience. And this is leaving a lot of people feeling very uneasy about the move. Okay, so there's the obvious benefits of digitizing your birth certificate, social security card, bank cards, and other important documents. If there's ever a fire or things get stolen, get backups online. Most of us keep our money in the bank with some sort of benefits. If somebody were to break into my house, for example, they're not going to find my entire life savings laying around in my bedroom. And I'm sure there was some level of resistance back in the day when companies wanted to start cutting checks to their employees rather than paying them in cash. I'm sure there were plenty of people who were skeptical of it and didn't want to have to hand over their money to a bank. So I understand there's natural levels of resistance and even paranoia whenever there's some sort of change in the way we live our lives. But if my employees really wanted to be paid in cash, I suppose I could do it. No one's forcing me to cut checks or direct deposit. But when something's being federated, the choices begin to dwindle. As it is, currently about a billion people around the globe have no form of identification, no way to prove who they are. Their births are unrecorded. They were never registered with their government's vital records departments, if their government even had one at all. We get into enormous debates in this country about using IDs to vote. The reason being, many people are without official government IDs. Lots of people currently can't fly in a plane because they lack a quote-unquote real ID and have since lost their birth certificates or other forms of necessary ID to secure one. So a lot of people are already disenfranchised because they lack an official form of government identification. It isn't just about voting or traveling. It's about opening bank accounts, registering for social services, and renting an apartment. Of course, those who advocate for a digital identification system claim that the digital ID will solve many of these problems. If your vitals and attributes are on record, such as fingerprints or facial recognition, then the government will always know who you are and you'll never get lost in the system. They'll also always know where you are and what you buy, and who you visit, where you travel, and which medicine you take, and what you're allergic to. They might want to use digital identification before you can log on to the internet so they can know which websites you visit and social you post. And I'm sure this will all be done not only for convenience, but for safety, they'll say. And don't worry, I doubt anyone will hack your records and screw things up, like, for example, switch your allergies or your medications or make it look like you visited some nefarious website that inevitably lands you on a domestic terrorist watch list. I doubt the government will use this digital identification to prevent you from entering bars and restaurants, traveling, or getting a job for not complying with a mandate the government has issued. I'm sure the government won't want to use this federated digital identification system to implement a social credit system where the goodies in society get more than the baddies. Don't worry, these are all conspiracy theories. And we all know the conspiracy theorists have been completely wrong about absolutely everything during this pandemic. See, you have nothing to worry about. Let the banks make a system we all have to adhere to that follows the guidance of the World Economic Forum's Great Reset agenda that will be monitored by the government. Nothing to worry about. So this was just interesting. It happened to trend online. And it's just, again, one of those examples of, you know, the World Economic Forum has this Great Reset agenda and they say it all out loud. They've written books, they have websites, they have commercials saying you'll own nothing, but you'll be happy. And then this banker guy comes out and says, we want to do a federated digital ID system. And the World Economic Forum thinks it's a good idea. And this is causing people to go, what? I don't think so.
Yeah, the irony, of course, is that the private sector is really leading the way in expanding control of the public that is then going to be exploited by governments around the world.
Right.
It's a nightmare. And here it comes.
Well, and I don't understand why it can't just remain, and I'm sure Robbie will agree with this one being the libertarian, but a federated system is very different than just, like I mentioned, Apple, right, having my wallet on my phone and being able to just whip out and choose which credit card I'm going to use on my phone. That's one thing. That's a private sector doing something for convenience for the consumer. But
right.
A federated ID, that's like a whole different layer.
Yeah, and
what do you think of that?
And then where does it go from there in terms of, you know, what the government requires you to do with that, or what, you know, or do you have to show it before you go various places? I mean, what we've seen with the vaccine stuff, right, is a test run, and even before vaccines, like immigration status checks, you know, forcing businesses to check the immigration status of their employees. I was like totally against that. Conservatives, a lot of them were for it. Then now we see it with the vaccines. And like this just does not end. You just have to have a principled opposition to this kind of thing at all. And like no more saying you need some kind of ID to do things. Like
yeah, and believe it or not, once upon a time people would start cars with keys. They would get into their apartments or their houses with keys. Actually, my house, we couldn't even lock the door. It just came in and out. But. Now, because everything's becoming electronic, somebody...
Did you get two cars stolen recently?
I did, right? Yeah. Did get two cars stolen. We got one of them back.
Great.
By the way.
Oh, you did?
Yeah,
oh, interesting.
Police are on it.
In good shape? Was it in good shape or was it destroyed?
It's absolutely reeked of cigarette smoke, but otherwise perfectly good shape. But now, anyway, so if you get, let's say your landlord is upset with you and it wants to evict you, it can just change the electronic code.
Yeah, you refuse to wear a mask
just
at the gym when you were supposed to. Totally hypothetically, and you got in trouble, and they said, if you do this again, we're going to disable your key fob's access to the gym. Again, hypothetical scenario, not something I totally did go through very recently.
This can be used then as a system of control in a way that just makes it easier to control. Now, a landlord could in the past change the locks. the tenant then changes the locks back. It creates a tension and it balances the power out a little bit. What this does is it puts all of the power in the hands of somebody who's got a rule, because it's like, okay, not only do we have a rule in place, we can enforce it. We catch you with your mask below your nose, Robbie. All of a sudden, your key fob's not working, and your friends aren't going to let you in there because they probably won't. You know,
they don't want their key fobs to not work. I mean, I'm all for digitizing. I use a lot of stuff in my life that people are like, "What? You actually use that?" But again, it's my choice, and I can always reverse it. I don't have to use it if I suddenly feel uncomfortable, right? With like the robots in my house listening to all of my conversations or something. But I think then maybe once this does start to become part of the actual agenda, which I think it might quicker than we anticipate, this kind of federated ID system. Of course, the government would have to catch up with its tech in order to get to that point. But like you mentioned, Ryan, and like this banker mentions, if the banks are the ones that actually end up being in charge of it, and then they say, well, we've already got the security infrastructure, so we'll roll it out, and then the government just gets to regulate it.
Lick a shot!
You know, that's pretty scary.
Prison.
government programmed your brain. Humans only inflict pain. I've been around the world and know what everybody's thinking. The human race is taking small steps to extinction. We post-war scientists creating new inventions to occupy your time so there's no time to pay attention. Occupy your time so there's no time to pay attention. The human race is taking small steps to extinction. We post-war scientists creating new inventions to occupy your time so there's no time to pay attention.
Brave new world, it's a brave new
You're becoming very predictable.
Yeah, I guess so. You gotta smoke.
The United States is a no-smoking nation. No smoking, no drinking, no drugs, no women. Unless, of course, you're married. No guns, no foul language, no red meat.
Land of the free.